My dear friends, welcome back to BSpice. In this session, we'll continue with mastering cable, wherein we'll focus on cable types. Cable type in the sense, flame retardant cable and fire resistant cable. Okay, so prior to this, we have uploaded two videos on the same mastering cable. The first one was, we focus, you know, more on what is thermoplastic, you know, properties, and what is thermoset and how to choose a material for specific application, all those. Then the last video, focus on general information like, you know, insulation material, sheathing material, and definition of terms, basically the terminologies like, you know, flame retardant, fire resistant, and the standards IEC 60334, you know, all these 331. All these we talked about, and also the strand types we focused. So in this, we'll talk about the cable types. Okay, just we'll move on. So here in the flame retardant, you would have heard the term, right? FR, flame retardant. See here, the flame retardant has got a resistance to fire momentarily. How? By adding fillers in the PVC compound at the cost of decrease in the insulation property. By at least 10% as compared to the normal PVC. So basically, I'm comparing the PVC version with the flame retardant properties, okay? So the flame retardant actually have a resistance to fire momentarily, got resistance to fire momentarily by adding fillers in the PVC compound at the cost of decrease of insulation. So there is a bit of, you know, compromise in the insulation property by at least 10% as compared to the normal PVC. Okay, friends, right? So its conductor temperature withstanding capability remains only at 70 degrees centigrade, same as the ordinary PVC cable. So as far as the conductor withstanding, temperature withstanding capability is concerned, there is no issue. It's same as a PVC. But here, the advantage of flame retardant is it got a resistance to fire momentarily. Okay. So that's about the general idea about the flame retardant. Then we'll talk about flame retardant low smoke, FRLS. You would have heard this terminology, right? Flame retardant low smoke, FRLS. Okay. Here, friends, before going into the, you know, merits of the FRLS, we'll talk about PVC. You know, PVC has got flame retardant property. Okay. So due to its halogen content. Okay. So the fire in the flame retardant cable get extinguished immediately on removal of fire source. So, you know, the modern, you know, power industries, you know, chemical, all these PVC are bunched in a cable shaft, right? In cable tray, right? Yes. So in this case, you know, all these cable, the fire becomes self-sustaining, right? So due to the burning of PVC, here the challenge is, if you burn the PVC, you know, the dense corrosive smoke is emitted, right? Which makes this firefighting very difficult, okay? And also due to the poor visibility and toxic nature of smoke, okay? That's the challenge with the PVC, right? And additionally, you know, the content of the HCl, of the smoke, not only damages the equipment nearby, but also penetrates the RCC, reinforced cement concrete, okay? And corrodes the steel reinforcement also. So due to this, there is an extensive damage to the property. So this is the challenge with the PVC. Okay. Now, so in what way FRLS helps actually? Yeah. To overcome all this deficiency, FRLS, that is flame retardant low smoke PVC, was developed. You got it? Yes. So this PVC compound has got better fire retardant property. Yeah? And it emits a lower smoke as it fumes when it catches fire. Okay. So FRLS has a special flame retardant, low smoke emitting, toxic fume, suppressing property. That is the beauty. In addition to the properties required by the IS-694. Okay. So it has a special flame retardant, low smoking. Okay. And low smoke emitting and toxic fume suppressing property. Okay. In case of fire, conventional PVC gets thick black smoke, isn't it? Yes, and toxic fumes, right? Of hydrochloric acid, which really hampers the visibility, right? So FRLS not only emits very little smoke and toxic gases, but also retard, this is not toxic gases, it's a gases, but also retards them spreading of fire into new area. That is the point. FRLS not only emits very little smoke and toxic gases, but also retard the spreading of fire into new area. So that is the point. Resistance to fire momentarily. Okay, friends. So it is ideal for concealed conduit wiring in a multi-storied high-rise building, such as, you know, banks, hospitals, factories, commercial complexes, all actually. Okay. So flame retardant cable emit less toxic smoke. And hence people get more time to leave dangerous area or to avoid explosion. I hope this FRLS is good. Properties is clear, right? Okay. So to add on a few more, we talk about, you know, LOI, limiting oxygen index, temperature, okay? So FRLS PVC compound or flame retardant because of what? Better alloy. What is that? Limiting oxygen index and temperature index, that is TA, than the ordinary PVC. This is the point. But one thing, see, better alloy and TA does not guarantee better flame retardant properties. That one also we need to be watchful. Okay. So alloy and TA are only quality control tests. We know, right? Yes. And flame retardant testing is incomplete without finished cable testing as per IEC 60332 part 13. So that is the point. LOI and TA only quality guarantee, quality control test. So the flame retardant complete testing is incomplete without the cable testing in line with IEC 60332 part 13. So that is the point. Okay. So generally for controlling process in plants, friends, just remember, controlling process. I am not talking about safety shutdown. I am talking about process. Controlling process in plant, flame retardant cables are used. That is the point. So, fire retardant cable pay less attention to the safety of human life. That is the point. Okay. So, we talk about flame retardant. Okay. So, that is actually based on controlling the process in plant. Okay. Here, fire retardant pay less attention to the safety of human life. Okay. Now, I'll go to the one moment. Yeah. Yes. Correct. Yes. So, this is the point. Then we go to fire resistant now. Fire-resistant cable can ensure safety of electric conduction even at high temperature in case of fire. Friends, remember, ensure the safety of electric conduction, fire-resistant. The individual conductor are wrapped with layer of fire-resisting mica or glass tape, which prevent face-to-face, face-to-air contact, even after the insulation has been burnt away. So that is the beauty, fire resistant cable. Okay. So silicon rubber insulated cable are also used as a fire resistant cable. Generally for controlling the safety or shutdown in plant. What is that? ESG, emergency shutdown, fire and gas, FGS. Fire resistant cables are used. That is the beauty. Their flame retardant we talked about. Process. Here it's talking about safety, right? Okay. So fire resistant cable pay attention to the safety of the power supply. And additionally, friends, circuit integrity test is there in line with IEC 60331, also BS 6387. Okay. So the category C cable, it's all subjected to fire at 750 degrees centigrade C. Okay. For 3 hours with electricity flowing through it. This is also we need to, check actually for the fire resistant cable. Okay. So now we talked about flame retardant and we talked about fire resistant. Now we talk about bit of a coating. You know, you would have seen the coating, right? Tinned coating, silver coating, nickel, all this, right? That is what I'm going to explain here. There are three material used for coating. Copper conductor. See, copper conductor is a primary. So on top of that, we have a coating. Okay. There are three types. One is tin, silver, and nickel. Okay. Tin is the most common and used for improved corrosion resistance and solderability. Right? You understand. Okay. It's very simple. Silver coating also there. This one, you know, we use for a high temperature environment. What is that? 150 to 200 degree. It's also used for high frequency application, you know, where silver's high conductivity, you know, and also the skin effect, it's all work together to reduce the attenuation at high frequencies. Okay, that is about the silver. Then we have also nickel coating. This also used for the conductor that operate at more than around 200 to 450 degree high temperature. And at these temperature, you know, the copper actually, you know, oxidizes rapidly if not nickel plated. So that is why we have to do the nickel plated. Okay, that's it, friends. Very good. Right, good to go. So now we'll talk about the summary. Okay, flame retardant cable resists spread a fire into new area, right? Fire extinguished immediately on removal of fire source, right? Momentarily. Okay. Flame retardant cables are not rated to continue to operate in a fire and in all probability will not maintain the circuit integrity during a fire. So that is the thing. Flame retardant cable are not rated to continue to operate in a fire and in all probability will not maintain the circuit integrity during the fire. Okay. So that is flame retardant. Now we'll talk about fire resistant. Fire resistant cable maintains circuit integrity. That is the point. And most importantly, it continue to work for a specified time under defined condition. Okay. So fire resistant cable continue to operate in the presence of fire and are commonly referred to as circuit integrity cables. Fire resistant property are significant for critical circuits. That is, you know, life safety, safe and immediate plant shutdown. So this is about the short summary. Few more summary. You know, there is a vast difference between the cables that are rated flame retardant and those that have earned the rating of fire rated or fire resistive. Okay. So flame retardant cable, you know, resists the spread of fire into new area, right? So here the flame retardant cable only restricts the spread of fire by inhibiting the combustion, right, friends? Okay. Flame retardant cables are not rated to continue to operate in fire and in all probability will not maintain the circuit integrity, whereas fire resistant does. Okay, that's it. So your flame retardant cable is not a fire resistant cable, not a fire rated cable, not a fire survival cable. So that is the bottom line. Okay, fire rated cable continue to operate in the presence of fire and are commonly referred to as circuit integrity cable. When the need to maintain circuit integrity is essential, specify fire rated fire resistive cable for those critical circuits that need to work in order to assure life safety and plant shutdown. That's it, friend. Very simple. I hope you got a good insight on this, you know, flame retardant, fire resistant, okay? And bit of coating, all these. Thank you once again for watching. See you in the next video, okay? Thank you. Bye-bye. Take care.